A new twist.
Don't you think Sam should be back by now?
No, job hunting takes time.
If it hadn't been for me, he would have a job.
Oh, you're not going to start that again, are you? It's not your fault that Rachel wouldn't hire him.
I should have known better. I had a feeling about him applying.
There's no way that you could have known that Rachel would react quite the way she reacted.
Oh, no?
No.
Having me on the staff is one thing. Having my brother, too?
You know, you're forgetting that I'm the one that told Sam not to mention that the two of you were even related.
Either way, it's turned into a losing proposition.
Yeah, I wonder.
What?
If it's not more than that.
It's very clear. Rachel's got no use for anyone related to me. I want to be in my... downstairs.
Wait a minute. If Sam comes in, I'll tell him to come down. Okay? Good. Mac, hi.
Hello, Felicia.
Where's Rachel?
That's what I want to know.
Ah, look, let's sit down. You look a little ruffled.
Try desperate.
Really? Why?
Well, what's there's wrong? A real crisis at Bravo. That's why I've got to find Rachel.
I'm afraid I haven't seen her since this morning.
She was interviewing a young man for an assistant layout editor's job here.
Right.
And I gotta find this man. I need him tonight.
How about Arnold Schwarzenegger?
I'd rather see Eddie Murphy, if you don't mind.
Don't you two working women have to get up early in the morning?
It's only a two-hour movie, Grandma.
In my day, we got to sleep early the day before the job started.
I'll get a full 8 hours, I promise.
I can't believe you're starting at Corey tomorrow.
Neither can Rachel.
I can't wait to punch in.
Punch in? Give me a break. Amanda Corey's gonna punch a time clock.
You better believe it. She's like one of the guys.
Oh, sure.
No, I mean it, Julianne. I don't want any favors just because I happen to be the boss's daughter.
Uh-huh. So what department are you working in?
Doesn't matter. I just want to get there and dive in.
You know what you want? Do you need a menu?
Forget the movie.
Why?
You'll never guess who just walked in.
Who?
The hunk that was parking cars at your party the other night.
Hold. You can't take my night.
Well, I just did.
It's not a straight line.
It doesn't have to be a straight line. Look, man, I thought we could play a little chess without being at each other's throats.
My move.
John, come on, man. We sat down here to try to work things out.
Is that why you're making all the digs at dinner?
I wasn't making any digs at dinner. I need to talk to you. I need to know about Dad.
One thing, Mike. Subtle you ain't.
John, I gotta know if you blame me for Dad's death.
What are you trying to do, screw up my move?
John, I can't believe that that's a secret you've held against me all these 20 years. Come on, John. I just don't buy it.
You don't buy John's explanation either, do you, Donna?
If that's what John says, Michael.
There's gotta be more to it than that.
Forget it, Mike. It's over with. It's all out in the open. It's over.
I think John's right, Michael. I think you're just beating this thing to death.
Donna, I'm not trying to hassle John.
Then drop it.
I wish I could. I just find it awfully hard to believe that the secret you've held on to for the last 20 years is that you blame me for Dad's death.
Well, that's it. That and a lot of other junk.
Well, what junk, John? I mean, why don't you talk to me?
It's your move, Mike.
John, this doesn't make any sense.
Well, neither did that move.
Maybe it makes sense to John.
Like I said, it's a lot of stuff coming down on me.
No, John, I'm sorry, man. I just don't buy this.
Checkmate. Buy that.
Hey, Victoria, wait! Vicky!
Michael, I guess she heard you and John arguing.
Well, we weren't arguing.
Well, I still think she's upset about something. She hardly said anything at dinner.
Yeah, she's probably upset about the family conference. I know she was very uncomfortable.
She wasn't the only one.
I better go talk to her. John, this conversation is not over.
Michael is not going to give up. He is going to keep digging and digging.
So tell Michael the truth.
My head layout editor just walked out on me.
Just like that, huh?
Well, we had had some trouble for some time, but I never expected it to come to a head so fast.
So, what do you think you'll do?
Well, I promoted the assistant layout editor, but now I've got to fill his job.
So what you need is a new assistant.
That's right, and Rachel was interviewing a young man for that job, and she was very impressed by him.
Was she?
So now I gotta find Rachel to find that man. I'm in a real bind.
Well, no, maybe not.
Oh?
I know the guy she was talking to. Yeah, yeah.
Do you?
Yeah, yeah. He has a room right here. In fact, he's the one that told me that he had an interview with Rachel. His name is Sam Fowler.
Well, what are we waiting for? Can we get him up here?
Yeah, yeah, I think so. I'll go see. You just stay, have something to drink on the house, and I'll see if I can round up Mr. Fowler.
You may have just saved my life, you know.
Well, let's hope you're right.
That's him, all right. What a bod. Julianne, would you please quit staring? Look at those shoulders. I bet he works out.
They're okay.
Okay. Get a load of that bicep.
Julianne, he's going to see you.
I wish. Boy, would I love to run my hands through his hair.
What a car.
Yeah, I guess somebody comes to a party like this, they think they gotta make an entrance.
Why? The only one that sees it is you.
You know, this party's for a girl about your age.
So I heard.
She must be a real snob.
You might be surprised.
I don't think so. Besides, I'd rather be out here parking cars than inside with her.
Tom Cruise, move over. Get a load of those eyes. Amanda, quick.
Hi.
Weekdays on 69
3390. Did you say something?
Yeah, I said hi.
Oh, hi.
Whoa. What did I tell you?
This guy definitely has to be seen in the light to be appreciated.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well, I hope you're hungry.
I'm still a grown boy.
I noticed. Enjoy.
Thanks.
He's looking over here? Nope. Well, what's he doing? Eating. I think he's more interested in that burger than you.
Oh, yeah?
Give me 2 minutes.
I'm sorry, I didn't recognize you at first.
No?
We worked together, remember?
Yeah, sure, at the Corey's party.
Right, yeah, right.
Yeah, you got canned, didn't you?
Huh?
Well, I didn't see you parking cars anymore, so I figured you got fired.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I got fired.
You know what, the boss catch you goofing off in one of those limousines or something?
Exactly. Well, you know, easy come, easy go, right?
Well, listen, I hope you didn't need the bread.
No. I mean, I did, but... I have another summer job now, so it doesn't matter.
Really? That's fantastic. Yeah, yeah, I've been hitting the pavement myself.
Oh, really? Any luck?
Well, I thought I had a job, but it didn't pan out.
Well, you'll get something.
Yeah, I hope so. And soon, too, because money's getting real tight.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
Yeah, I guess we're not as lucky as that filthy rich spoiled brat, huh?
Who?
Oh, you know, that girl they were throwing the coming out party for.
Oh, her.
Yeah, I guess she's got it made, huh?
Yeah, guess so.
Funny thing is, she's probably never had a job in her life and probably never will either.
And probably not.
You know, people like that, they really kill me, you know?
Yeah, me too.
Well, hey, it was good running into you again, okay?
Yeah, same here.
Yeah, well, good luck with the job, too. Don't be sloughing off, either.
Oh, I won't. Don't worry. Okay. Well, have a good summer.
Yeah, you too.
So, what happened? I struck out. Well, you could have introduced me.
No, because if I introduced you, then I'd have to introduce me, too.
You mean you didn't even give him your name?
Are you kidding?
If he realized that I was that filthy, rich, spoiled brat, he wouldn't even give me the time of day.
I can't tell Michael that
Oh, come on, Donna. It was a long time ago. We were just kids.
Oh, and that's supposed to make it all right?
What has right and wrong got to do with this? Tell him. Get it out in the open.
I can't do that. You know that.
Why not? It's not like we were in love, right?
No. I was in love with Michael.
Well, there you go. So tell him that what happened between us that night was meaningless.
It was.
And what's the problem?
It's just too late now.
Too late for what, Donna?
I should have told Michael right away.
Why didn't you?
Because I didn't know how, that's all.
Ah. So are you going to keep on lying to him? Is
that
it?
Don't call it that.
Well, that's what it is.
No. No, everything is just out of control right now. Don't you see that?
No, I don't.
John, I had to make up that story about what you were going to tell him in Vietnam.
Really? Oh, come on, Donna. Go ahead and tell Michael. He'll understand. He's a reasonable guy.
No. No, he would never understand why I'm keeping something like this from him.
Tell him what happened. We were kids. You were mad at him. You wanted to make him jealous, right?
That's right. Because it never would have happened otherwise.
You explain it to him. He'll forgive you.
No. No, he won't. It's already gone too far.
What's gone too far?
I have worked so hard at being the kind of wife that Michael deserves. And I am not going to lose him now.
Oh, I don't think you'll lose him.
Michael can never find out.
You're making a big mistake.
I already made the mistake.
Then set it right.
I can't. Don't you understand? Michael would never believe what happened between us was meaningless when he realizes how hard I worked to cover it up.
Are you afraid that what happened between us wasn't meaningless?
What?
That night in the car. Maybe it wasn't meaningless. Maybe it really meant something to you, Donna.
What you looking at? Family photos?
No, just some pictures of furniture the antique store sent over.
You want a second opinion?
No, I have a bunch of stuff to look through myself first.
Good idea. Trust your instincts, that's what I always say.
Is that what you do, Uncle John? Always trust your instincts?
Most of the time.
Well, what if you're wrong?
If you're wrong, you start over.
Sometimes that's not so easy.
Look, I'm sure whatever furniture you choose will be great.
Well, I have a lot of time to decide that, right?
Well, not that long. I should be finished here in about a month or so.
And then what?
Then you can start moving in.
I meant, and then what will you do? After all the reconstruction is finished.
Well, I haven't really thought about it.
Are you gonna live in the house?
I think it's time I moved on.
Don't you like living with Michael and Donna?
I like being single.
I thought you were gonna be part of the family, Uncle John, just like Michael said.
You want me to stay?
Not sure.
Well, at least you're honest.
What I meant is, I just don't know if I know you very well. Do I, Uncle John?
You can eat your pie.
I'm busy.
I guess we're not gonna get to the movie tonight, are we? Who cares?
I don't believe it.
What?
He ate the whole thing.
I told you, I'm a grown boy.
Oh, remember that. Oh, I'm sorry, I can't take that.
Why not?
Well, we have a $10 minimum on credit cards. Your check's only $5.
I think we've got a problem.
You're low on cash.
I spent my last buck on the bus. Look, it's either this or I start washing dishes.
I'd rather take my chances on the plastic.
Thanks. Look, I'm really too bummed out to wash dishes anyway.
Have a rough day?
Yeah, the worst. I'm trying to find a job.
Uh-huh. That can make for a rough day. Mary's place.
Ada, hi. It's Felicia.
Why do I get the feeling something's wrong?
Oh, Ada, I'm sorry. It's just that I'm a little desperate right now.
For what?
A guy, actually.
You are not alone.
No, I'm looking for one particular guy. I've called all over Bay City.
Who is he?
His name is Sam Fowler. You haven't seen him, have you?
Guess what?
What?
I just served him the biggest hamburger in America. It's for you.
Hello?
Sam, thank heavens I found you.
Who is this?
It's Felicia.
There's nothing wrong with my brother, is there?
No, no, Mitch is fine. Now listen, can you get over to Tops right away?
Yeah, sure, but what's up?
You want to work for Matt Corey or not?
Well, yeah, of course I do, but I thought that was a dead issue.
No, it's just been resurrected.
I'm sorry, what?
Yeah, Mac is sitting here right now, and he wants to see you.
He does?
He does. Now stop playing 20 questions and get over here fast.
Okay, I'm on my way.
Listen, honey, just one thing.
Yeah, what?
Rachel hasn't spoken to Mac, so he doesn't know anything about you and Mitch.
Well, he's gonna find out sooner or later.
Just be cool about it, all right? Get the job first. Now, listen, I have to race out to see a friend, but you promise me you'll come see Mac?
I'll be there.
Good luck, honey.
Thanks, and thanks for finding me.
Okay.
Bye. Ooh, I just got lucky.
What happened?
I might have found a job.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
Ada.
Thanks, Ada. And this is mine.
Okay.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
I told you you'd get one.
Well, I haven't gotten the job yet.
You will.
My name's Sam. What's yours?
Julianne. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. And
Mandy Ashton.
Nice to meet you, Mandy. Well, hey, maybe we'll run into each other one of these days.
Maybe.
All right, thanks. Goodbye.
Mandy Ashton. It's a nickname, okay? My friends in Paris gave it to me. Besides, it isn't exactly like I'm lying to them.
Who, you?
Anyway, I decided to use that name at Corey, too.
Amanda, that's crazy.
I told you, I wanted to do this on my own.
What about all the people that saw you at your party the other night? You'll never pull it off.
Corey employs thousands of people. I don't know why you're making such a big deal out of it.
Well, because, I mean, if they know that my name is Corey, I'll never be judged on my merits, let alone social life.
Oh, come on, you'll have guys lined up around the block.
Right. Every preppy in town.
Sam's no preppy.
I noticed.
I hate to say it, but I don't think he's interested.
Oh, yeah?
Well, listen, want to go catch a movie?
Okay, let's go. I'll be right there.
Sam Fowler.
I had my own boat. Sailed all over Southeast Asia.
Didn't you ever get lonely?
You know, there's a special feeling that you get when you're at sea. You're never really lonely. It's like you're the only one in the whole world. You're free.
Yeah, I used to feel that way when I was driving my car through the deserts in California.
There you go. Something else we have in common.
Like Michael and Donna?
Among other things.
You didn't want to move back here, did you, Uncle John?
No, I'm too set in my own ways.
Is that the only reason?
What is this, the third degree?
Oh, no, I just want to get to know you better.
Well, what you see is what you get.
Did you leave anybody back in Southeast Asia?
Like who?
A wife? Kids?
No, on both counts.
Why didn't you ever get married?
Because I like being single.
Is that it?
Not everyone wants to sink into domestic bliss like your father.
Haven't you ever been in love, Uncle John?
You're watching another...
Have I ever been in love?
Yeah, come on, John.
Who was she, huh?
Yes, Uncle John, you can tell us.
I bet your Uncle John has been in love so many times he can't match the name with the face, eh?
Whatever you say, hotshot.
Don't call him that.
Hey, 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 honey, it doesn't mean anything.
It's a put-down and he knows it.
If I ever get into a scrape, I want you on my side.
Victoria, don't mind him, really, I'm used to it.
Well, I'm not.
Okay.
How can you treat him like that?
Hey, look, it's no big deal.
It is to me. You're my father. You see how hard he tries to get the two of you together. Why can't you try to make it work? Why do you always keep throwing in pot shots all the time?
I got some things I gotta do.
You're a real tiger, you know that?
I don't know why you let him get away with that.
Honey, I think you were a little hard on John.
He has no right to make fun of you.
Hey, look, that's just what John does. That's just his way.
Well, he's gonna have to change his ways because I'm not listening to it.
Victoria, I thought you and John liked each other.
Yeah, well, I don't like when he starts cutting down the family.
I have a feeling you're a little more upset about all the arguing that went on last night.
I'm not upset.
Oh, no? Well, then why you got these little frown lines right there around your mouth?
I don't understand why you put up with him. Why don't you just throw him out?
Victoria, I love my brother.
How can you love a guy that does that to you?
Happens to be the only brother I've got.
No. I think it's something more, Michael. I want to know. What is it between you and Uncle John?
Mr. Corey.
Yes.
Yes, I'm Sam Fowler.
Oh, Mr. Fowler. Very glad to meet you. Please sit down.
Thank you.
I had quite a time locating
you. Oh, I'm terribly sorry.
No, no, it's all right, long as we've connected. My wife spoke very highly of you.
Did she?
Yes, and then I didn't hear anything. I hope you didn't decide on another job.
No, I've been thinking it over.
Ah. Well, I'd like to talk to you about working for me, if you're still interested.
Well, yes. I mean, why not?
Well, let's have a look at your work.
All right. Yes, sir.
I mean, you sounded so upset on the phone.
Oh, I know, I know. I am so glad you're here.
This is about John again, isn't it?
Huh? Alicia, everything just keeps getting worse and worse.
I was hoping you were going to tell me that he was moving out.
Oh, I wish that were true, but I know that's not going to happen now.
Donna, you know, maybe you're just going to have to ask him. Tell him. Tell him he's putting a strain on your marriage.
You think he doesn't know that?
You've got to make some kind of action here.
I know, but you don't understand. Michael is not going to let him leave this house. And Felicia, I am just getting in deeper and deeper. I never should have told Michael that John blames him for their father's death.
But Michael did accept that, didn't he?
Sort of. He's just asking all kinds of questions
about it.
But
John is backing you up,
I Yes, hope. Yes, of course he is. But now John's saying that he thinks I should tell Michael the truth, that Michael would understand.
I agree with him. I think he's right. I don't think it's too late.
No. No, if I tell Michael what happened, he is going to wonder why I worked so hard to cover it up.
Donna, honey. You know, I think you're underestimating Michael's love for
you.
No.
No, if I tell Michael, Felicia, I am going to lose him. I know I will lose him.
Can I ask you something? As a friend.
Of course you can.
Is John Hudson staying in this house because he thinks that you don't want him to leave?
No. No, of course I want him to leave. He knows that.
I guess what I'm really asking you is, you feel something for John? I mean, are you guilty about that? And that's why you're not telling Michael the truth?
Are a tradition.
So you do feel something for John, don't you?
Yes. Something.
Honey.
It's not like anything that I have with Michael or feel for Michael. I love Michael. I know I don't love John, but Felicia, I don't know what it is.
Maybe it's the excitement. What you can't have.
Maybe. It's just that I know I love Michael so much. I want to have another baby with him. Michael's the only man I've ever loved. I don't love John. I know that.
Okay, now look. This is not a crime here. You can love your husband. And you can think somebody else is attractive.
Yes, but John isn't just somebody else.
You're right. He is your husband's brother, and you got to stop this. You've got to put John Hudson out of your life,
Donna.
I
have tried, Felicia.
Now, listen to me. Everybody is tempted in their lives once in a while. You don't have to feel guilty about that. It's very human.
But I do feel guilty. I mean, Michael would never find himself in this situation. He's always so cut and dried about everything.
You know what? I think you're putting impossible demands on yourself because nobody, honey, nobody is perfect.
Michael is, and he expects everybody else to be.
Now listen to me. You said you wanted to have another baby with Michael, didn't you?
I do more than anything.
I think that you should concentrate on that, and I think you should make every effort to get John Hudson out of your life.
But what if I can't?
You have to. Now listen to me. You have to. Before this attraction for John turns into something that you just can't control.
Why do you make excuses for him after all he put you through?
Honey, because I guess I know John better than you do. I know that he holds a lot of things in.
What things?
He holds his feelings in, for one. Honey, look, the only reason that he screams and he yells like that is because he doesn't know how to show that he cares.
Well, that's ridiculous.
Hey, it's not ridiculous. Not if you're as afraid of being hurt as John is. kind of like somebody else we might know?
I am nothing like Uncle John.
Hey, hey, now don't you sell your uncle short there. He's got a lot of very admirable qualities.
Like what?
Mickey, take a look. He's got this wild kind of energy. I envy that.
Dad, you're successful. You're rich. Uncle John has nothing like that.
Your Uncle John has a lust for life. He's got a sense of adventure.
Well, I bet Uncle John would just love to trade places with you.
Well, I'll tell you something. I wouldn't mind trading places with Uncle John for a couple of days.
How can you say that? You care about people. You go out of your way.
So does your Uncle John.
Yeah, to cause trouble.
Hey, got a story for you. When we were kids, mid-semester, new kid comes into school, right? Doesn't know a soul. He's from Mexico, named Lopez, doesn't speak a word of English.
I guess he felt pretty out of place.
You got it. So what happens? One afternoon, as we're leaving school, I watch John run over to Lopez, drag him out of the basketball court, stick a ball into his hands. Before you know it, they're dribbling all around the court, having a great old time. And old Lopez, there he's grinning from ear to ear, smiling, having a great time. It was just beautiful.
Well, that doesn't sound much like Uncle John.
Tell you what happened when I went over to John and I told him what a beautiful thing I thought he did. You know what he said?
What?
He said, hey, I was just looking for a basketball partner. I couldn't care less.
Yeah, well, maybe he couldn't.
No. See, that's just the way John is, Vicky. Tell you something else, John is a lot smarter than I am.
How can you say that? You build a whole business empire all by yourself.
It's not that kind of smarts I'm talking about. John has survival instinct. See, I couldn't have gone through what John went through in Vietnam and come out of it alive.
You were in the war, too.
I came out of it in one piece.
Well, if it wasn't for you, Dad, Uncle John never would have come out at all.
Vicky, someday, I hope that you can see your Uncle John like I see your Uncle John.
I know what I see. And I think Uncle John might not be the type of person you think he is.
Victoria, I know my brother. I love my brother. My brother loves me, even though he can't show it, and he would never, ever do anything to hurt me. He couldn't, ever.
Yeah, well, I hope you're right.
I am. And you'll see. Someday you'll get to know John as well as I do. You'll see I'm right.
Another family conference?
I better be getting home.
Mike, I want you to take a look at these plans. The architect really messed up here.
Okay. Wrong. Vicky, wait up. Look, can I take these with me? What page?
Four.
Four. Got it. Thanks.
Excitement.
Can you?
indeed.
Whatever you want. You're fired.
What?
I want you out of my house and out of my life tonight.
And what will Mike say tomorrow morning?
Leave Michael to me.
I already did that. You know, Michael go nuts if I leave.
I will make him understand.
Ah. Like you made him understand about the secret that I've been keeping from him all these years?
No, I had to say something.
If you'd kept your big mouth shut, I'd have been gone by now.
Well, what's stopping you now?
Mike. He wants us to be a family, to work this thing out. He feels real bad that I blame him for our daddy's death.
I told you I had to say that.
Who are you trying to protect, Donna? You? Or me?
No, don't you dare.
You don't really believe what you said before, do you?
What are you talking about now?
About what we had. Being meaningless. It wasn't meaningless, was it, Donna? Say it wasn't meaningless.
Won.
It wasn't meaningless, was it, Donna?
Let me go.
No, you felt something for me when we made love.
No!
You still feel it.
You want to know what I really feel?
That's why you lie to Mike, isn't it?
I feel revolted every time I think about it. That's what I really feel.
Stop
every time you touch me, it makes me sick. No, I don't.
Admit it,
don't let me go.
You two were going to the movies.
We tried.
They were rerunning last week's feature.
And we had already seen it.
This night is turning into a real drag.
Uh-huh. You always liked a nice glass of chocolate milk when you had a big disappointment. Coming up.
Well, we could go to a club, check out the action.
Yeah.
No. I'm just not in the mood. Even if we saw that guy again?
Something tells me he isn't the club-going type.
Maybe, but it's worth a try.
No, I can't.
Why not?
Well, Grandma was right before.
Again? What about?
Well, tomorrow is my first day at Corey, and I want to make sure I at least get some rest.
Yep. You can't prove Rachel's wrong about anything unless you get a good night's sleep.
I know.
But the night is young.
You know, besides, I want to talk to my dad.
About what?
My new name. And if you say anything, I'll kill you.
Hey, my lips are sealed. Mandy Ashton.
You don't think it's too Hollywood, do you?
Oh, no.
Maybe I should go there tonight.
You're gonna go to Corey Publishing tonight?
Well, I think my dad's working late. He can give me a ride home.
Why tonight?
Because tomorrow morning, I am walking in there as Mandy Ashton. And I just want to make sure there's no one there to blow my cover.
Did you know that guy was just here?
I'm swearing off, guys.
What?
Well, for now. I mean, for now, I'm a career girl.
Amanda, you saw what that guy looked like.
I have to prove to my parents that I can do this job. So, for a while, the good-looking guys are just gonna have to wait.
I told Mrs. Corey that I thought layout had a statement of its own to make.
Well, yours certainly does.
Really?
I'm very impressed, Mr. Fowler.
Thank you. Please call me Sam.
Well, Sam, the job is yours, if you want it.
It is? I mean, well, yeah, I do. Boy, do I want this job. Thank you, Mr. Corey. Really, thanks.
had a hunch that might work out.
Are you saying that you had something to do with this?
Who, me?
No, don't give me the who, me routine.
No.
Welcome to Corey Publishing.
Thank you. When do I start?
Well, would tonight be too soon?
Tonight?
You see, my new art editor is working on the cover, and we're really in a bit of a crunch. I know it's a lot to ask.
No, it's not, really. Tonight's fine.
Well, let's go over to the office. So let me get this. You know, Rachel was right. You're gonna do great things for Bravo.
Original SoapNet show that was nominated for 4 Emmy Awards in its first season, including Best Hosts. Lisa and Ty give you inside access to the world of soaps every weekday at 9 a.m. and 7 p.m. Soap Talk, only on SoapNet, the new way to watch soaps.